this a minute ago, but it's still a shocking figure. 12 million Americans still have holiday purchases on their credit cards from last year. But paying as you go with your debit card is not necessarily the answer either. Sometimes there are serious drawbacks to using your debit card.
More and more people say they're using debit cards to avoid running up credit card debt.
I can control my money that way. I know what I can spend and what I can't spend.
That is a plus with debit cards. But Consumer Reports says it can be a mistake to use debit cards for big holiday purchases or even small ones you might want to return.
With a debit card, if you have a problem with the purchase, you can't dispute the charge the way you can with a credit card.
And for big ticket items like electronics, debit cards rarely give you a longer warranty, something you get automatically with many credit cards. Consumer Reports also advises against shopping online with a debit card. If your security is compromised, thieves could drain your entire bank account.
And if you don't report fraudulent activity on your debit card within 2 business days, you can be on the hook for $500 or more. With a credit card, your losses are limited to $50.
Another big minus with debit cards, if you spend more than you have in your account, you'll likely be socked with a hefty overdraft fee. If you don't have a credit or debit card, you might be tempted to use prepaid gift cards. But Consumer Reports says those can be a bad deal.
There may be a fee to activate it and a fee every time you use it. There may even be a fee when you don't use the card.
So this holiday season, using a credit card is a smart money move, but only if you keep your balance under control and pay it off promptly.
Bottom line, they say, for small purchases that you're not likely to return, it's fine to use the debit card. But if you're concerned about identity theft, press the credit option when using your card.